first our top story tonight, and that's the furor over a lobbying disclosure report filed by Walmart in the United States, stating that it paid $25 million, that's approximately 125 crores over 4 years, for lobbying with various officials and politicians in the United States. This included, they said, lobbying for discussion on FDI in India. It's created a political storm here, but for more on that, let's go across to Sarah Jacob in New York. Sarah, the point being, of course, that lobbying is legitimate in the United States. In fact, the Indian government itself hires lobbying firms. But the question being raised is, what does lobbying for FDI in India actually translate into when it comes, when it really trickles down to India in a sense?
Well, Sonia, I'm not really sure how much this actually translates down to India in the sense, because what this means that they're lobbying for the Senate, for the houses in Congress, and for the government to basically push India to be more open to FDI. For example, let's say when Hillary Clinton, the Secretary of State, meets, let's say, former Foreign Minister S.M. Krishna, when we would cover those events, there would be people who would encourage her to push him on saying that India should do more for foreign direct investment. Everybody knows that major retailers the world over consider India to be a huge market where they can gain. And as proponents of opening up the economy in India say, both India and the U.S. can gain. So like you said, lobbying is absolutely legal in the U.S. It's most common. It's also considered to be necessary for the functioning of politics in America. People lobby for on all issues, whether it's gay rights, whether it's foreign direct investment or opening up economies. But clearly now the BJP claims, or the opposition in India is now claiming, that this is illegal and there may have been some bribery. Can we follow up and actually find some evidence of that? Because clearly most of the bargaining, or the most of the lobbying, I should say, here in the US that Walmart has paid lobbyists for has been for local issues in America, whether it's taxes, whether it's healthcare. All of this would affect Walmart and its employees. So if the BJP or the opposition is making these allegations, perhaps we'll see in the next few days some proof of this and whether they can come up with that.
At the root of the latest FDI blowout, this bunch of US documents detailing how Walmart spent $25 million in lobbying in the last 6 years in the United States. Part of that, as the documents show, was for enhanced market access for investment in India and discussions related to Indian FDI. This document shows that the quarter beginning April this year, Walmart spent $1.49 million on lobbying. These expenses in 11 areas, one of which was India. The latest development for the quarter ending September shows Walmart's lobbying expenses at $1.6 million. India was one of the 12 expenses listed. Lobbying is legal in America, but not in India.
FDI ki sawari घूस और लॉबिंग के कंधों पर चढ़कर हिंदुस्तान में आई है, ये एफटीआई खुद वॉलमार्ट ने माना है। हम चाहेंगे इस पूरे मामले की जांच हो, इस पूरे मामले की ईमानदार जांच हो और स्वयं प्रधानमंत्री जी इसका उत्तर दें।
आई डू थिंक दैट द लोकसभा शुड डिस्कस दिस इश्यू ऑफ वॉलमार्ट ट्राइंग टू गेट इन टू इंडिया थ्रू इनलीगल मींस।
वॉलमार्ट इटसेल्फ सेज इट हैज स्पेंट दिस मनी। There are cases of corruption in the courts. So you have an independent inquiry into it.
Just last week, the government had won a bruising numerical showdown on the issue of FDI in retail. The government has had no time to celebrate. The report is ill-timed and virtual dynamite. The opposition is protesting, asking for a probe. Even the allies are protesting. The crisis is the government is saying no, and the friction over this issue may perhaps stall proceedings in parliament.
The allegation which they are raising, the opposition is raising, see Ravi Shankar Prasad, deputy leader of BJP, is raising, that is relating to USA. Our Indian government is nothing to do with that, because if he wants to raise the issue, he can raise it in USA, not here.
Walmart has so far refused to comment. However, in India, Walmart is already in trouble. In November, the company suspended its chief financial officer and their legal officials as part of a global investigation, potential violations of America's anti-bribery laws. In December, the Enforcement Directorate began a probe after an MP's complaint that Walmart broke India's FDI rules when it invested $100 million in SEDA's support services, earlier known as Bharti Retail Holdings. India Inc., however, has reacted cautiously.
It's legal, to my mind. Lobbying is legal in India. What kind of lobbying? If you mean by lobbying using underhand means or corrupt means to get to an objective, it's illegal, and it's illegal in the United States too.
So how exactly do you define lobbying? Why is it a dirty word in India, as it were? Sir, just to ask, because of course this Walmart report comes in the context of, we've seen recent inquiry being ordered by Walmart into bribery allegations in India. The chief financial officer actually stepped down. You of course remember the Enron scandal, when there's again issues about corruption at that time. So given the context, these kind of disclosures, also the New York Life Insurance Company, which I mentioned, these are very controversial, very sore political points in India. And what's not clear in these disclosure reports is what kind of lobbying it was. Clearly, money has not been given to the U.S. Secretary of State for lobbying. So what kind of lobbying is this money actually being used for? How much is actually being spent? Those details aren't there.
Listen, the details, the amounts are there, the names are there of who they've spoken to. Mm-hmm. So how lobbyists work, the system basically is, it's almost in a sense like having a PR firm who can explain your stand or put it more eruditely across to politicians. So basically, I, for example, if I were Walmart, I would hire a lobbying firm, right, who could meet with members of Congress and try and put forward to them why we should have better relations with US and India, for example. That's what the US-India Business Council, for example, would do. They would lobby for better Indo-US relations. So they pay these people to then speak to politicians, but one is assuming that politicians listen to all points of view and then take a decision based on the best interest of their country. Now, obviously, at some point of time, there have been lots of controversies over lobbying in the United States. Many people do say that perhaps lobbyists have way too much power in the corridors of power in Washington, but also there's this fine line. People say it's protected by freedom of speech and everybody has a right to put forward their points of view, mm-hmm, but there's a fine line between when one can go overboard and not. But clearly, as you can see, Sonia, Walmart, even though FDI was passed in Parliament last week, the sky seemed pretty grey, just like it is here in New York this morning.
Sarah Jacob, thanks so much for joining us live from New York. Let's go across to the rest of my panel. Sarah talked about crossing the line, the corridors of power in Washington. The issue really here is about New Delhi, and the timing of course couldn't be worse, just as the government was celebrating its FDI win, the opposition seizing on this new Walmart lobbying report. Well, joining me tonight, Mr. P.C. Chacko, MP spokesperson of the Congress, also Mr. Prakash Javdekar, again MP and spokesperson of the BJP. Also with me, Shogata Roy of the Trinamool Congress, a former minister, and Mr. M.B. Rajesh of the CPIM, and Dilip Charan describes himself as corporate lobbyist as well and doesn't see it as a dirty word, and Vikram Mehta, our corporate voice and former chairman of the US-based Shell Group. Thank you all very much for joining us tonight. Prakash Javdekar, let me go across to you first, because as Mr. Narayanasamy put it earlier, if you have an issue with the Walmart lobbying in the US, go and raise it in the US. Why is it an issue for India at all?
This is ridiculous and atrocious argument. We are raising the issue about India and in India, and we'll continue to raise it in India. We have nothing to do what US companies do it in US. The issue is, there are three specific things. First, Walmart is trying from 2008 for access in India, and they tried hard and they spent $25 million.
$25 million is overall lobbying, not just for India. No, sir, but that's a fact I wanted to correct. $25 million is overall lobbying, not just for India.
But that is what I am telling. Hmm. But second is, there is action, subsequent action on Indian five officers relating to Walmart. Their chief finance officer in India and four other officers, legal officers, are suspended. Mm-hmm. Means why? Because they have violated the American anti-bribery law. So when you are violating anti-bribery law of America, you are violating bribery law of India also. Because right, otherwise they would have taken action somewhere else. They have taken action in India. That means there is something what is being illegally done in India.
Agreed,
and that is what now we want through inquiry. And last but not least, the issue is that we have seen Enron, Bofors, how they spent on educating the lawmakers or educating the rulers or the decision makers. So this is the new name of bribery, and that is why it's a very serious issue, because they are not coming here. Walmart is not coming in India for charity. They are coming for their profits.
Well, no corporate,
and that
I
is
presume.
Why I'm sure this is a serious.
I'm sure Vikram Mehta would agree with me that no corporate is coming for charity, whether they're Indian or multinational. But let me just ask, because you made a series of allegations, so let me just get Mr. Chacko to respond. Mr. Chacko, the question being, again, I know what the government's response was earlier today, but what does this translate into? Okay, they're allowed to lobby with US lawmakers and they pay PR firms or lobbyists to do that. But what does this mean? Does this mean US politicians come, tell Indian politicians, and it's all hunky-dory? There's nothing, there's no question of any exchange of money, there's no question of corruption at all involved here. Isn't the timing significant? And the fact that Walmart is already facing corruption allegations here, which they are inquiring into themselves.
Sonia, the disappointment of the opposition parties in India who oppose the FDI is understandable. That does not mean that they can go to this extent. There is a report placed before the American Congress. That is about the irregularities or regular, whatever legal or illegal, whatever had happened for the lobbying. They have placed the report. And how does it concern to India government? What is the information India government is having? Today the BJP members were shouting at the height of their voice in parliament that the government should come out with a response.
No, because the money is paid for lobbying in India. So the implication is that there is influence being used in India, surely. That's what the opposition is arguing about.
Then Sonia, the question is whether they are trying to influence those who are opposing the FDI or whether they are going to influence those who are supporting the FDI. What is the necessity of lobbying
That's
with anybody
point.
In the government? Because we are for FDI, and why should they spend their time and money for us? Because if anybody
why waste the money and convert it is a point that
here
you get the unconverted. Let me get the unconverted point, Mr. Javdekar. It's not just you. I've got Shogata Roy also
here
in Parliament. Well, some would say make a fair point. The money can go to politicians of all views. Why are you presuming it's to the government? They had put their buck behind it, as it were, a year and a half ago.
No. Let Javdekar and Roy find out where it has gone.
No, we want to.
No,
we wonder what our
is
demand is.
Congress wants
Mr.
Chandra,
I'm going to come back to you. Let Mr. Shogata Roy speak. I'll come back to you right after that. Yeah.
I also said in Parliament that the government should investigate as to which are the Indian politicians this US lawmakers influence. First, Walmart.
Influence is different than paying money and talking
please,
to
please, 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 listen to me. Unless anybody is proof taking money.
Mm-hmm.
We cannot make an allegation. It can only be proved if a proper investigation takes place. From the first day, I have been saying that this agreement to have FDI multi-brand retail has been done under American pressure. And I took the risk of naming the US Secretary of State as high dignitary as that, much to the charging of the ruling.
Though
but
I mentioned
please.
To you earlier that Mamata Di also met the same US Secretary
yes.
of State in Calcutta and
but,
gave her a
but, yes,
red
yes.
carpet welcome.
No. She gave her a red carpet.
Why is it
carpet.
Okay if she meets Mamata Banerjee?
No, not okay if she meets the Prime Minister. There is no problem if she meets anybody. But did Mamata speak in favor of FDI in retail after Mrs. Clinton met her? That is the point. Mrs. Clinton, I would request you to do one thing, Sonia, mm-hmm. your advanced people. You just type two words, Walmart and Hillary Clinton, and then do a Google search. You know, I did that, and immediately what came out? Walmart and Hillary, an unfinished love affair. This is an article in a magazine called Buffington Post, published in the USA. So it has been a long stand. You know where Walmart headquarters are situated? In Bentonville, Arkansas.
No, it's like Enron and George Bush. It was like Enron and George Bush.
Like,
we actually go back. But
who are the most famous couple in Arkansas? You know who they are, the Clintons. So I am saying that the lobbying has started from the top. I have no proof of any Indian politician having taken money. But it has been proved that Walmart has been trying to get into the 500 billion Indian market. And for that, they have already influenced US politicians. We want the government to find out which Indian politicians they influenced. Obviously, the American pressure was there. How it was Exactly.
So how do you define pressure? Let me just first get in Mr. Dilip Charin, because Dilip Charin, I think one arm of your group also deals has the account of Bharti Walmart. Just to ask you, how do we define pressure? Do you feel that it crosses a line when, say, a Hillary Clinton, or it could be X, it could be the head of the Indo-US Business Council, it could be a corporate lobbyist like you. Suppose you meet a politician and say that I think this is a good deal and we should do it. Does that cross a line? Do you think crossing a line is when money is paid, which would then of course come under the Prevention of Corruption Act? Or do you think a conversation or lobbying or pitching your client's cause is legitimate?
You know, first of all, just sort of matter of full disclosure, we do communications advice for Walmart, and we've done it very much in the public domain, mm-hmm. and we continue to do that. That's one. The second thing is that here a lot of mud is being thrown at this point of time on the concept of lobbying, on the concept of PR, and who's doing what. Just focus for a moment on America and where the report to Congress is. Indian companies, as well as India, have been lobbying just as much, using lobbying firms in America, fully cognizant. After all, you've got to hold up a mirror to yourself. You can't say that something is illegal, which is done by firms in India today, by the Indian government just yesterday, and you can't say that that is illegal. Secondly, what Mr. Roy and Mr. Javadekar are saying of money being paid to Indian politicians, I don't think, in my understanding, that is the way how lobbying works. That is the way how fixing works.
Well,
that
is not. It won't be a disclosure anyway. It won't be a
right.
disclosure.
The second thing is that most American firms recognize that while they have to make disclosure on their lobbying thing, they also have a very powerful FCPA Act, the Foreign Corrupt Practices Act, as far as Americans are concerned. So they are not able to, they are not about to disclose in one report what they are going to get slammed at in another report. The FCPA's provisions in terms of bribery of any foreign official are actually far more stringent.
But sometimes, you know, yes, because in fact, Mr. Rajiv, we come in here, we know that Walmart has had huge issues with payments in Mexico.
Absolutely.
And
absolutely.
Many have compared the Mexico example to India and made that point. Mr. Rajesh, when we come in on lobbying and Dilip Charin's point, the argument would be that in a country like India where so many inequalities still exist, of course we have lobbyists from people who can pay for it. But does that lead to a unequal playing field when there are so many in India whose voices may not be adequately represented because they may not be able to hire a PR firm or a lobbying firm or can't get to the people in the corridors of power besides, say, perhaps their local MLAs or MPs?
They have NGOs. They have NGOs.
You say NGOs are lobbyists in a way?
Across the world, NGOs are considered a form of lobbying, as are trade associations.
Go ahead.
Of course. Because when there is a conflict between business interests and the interests of people, then these business groups can hire these lobbies for to protect their interests. But how can people, common people, can hire lobbies for to protect their interests? So lobbying is nothing but bribery in disguise.
Even the lobbying by NGOs, as Dilip Charin puts it, what about trade unions? What about NGOs? Isn't that lobbying in a way?
Trade unions are not doing lobbying.
Lobbying and making demands
is a collective bargaining. It's a collective bargaining.
Bargaining and lobbying is different.
No, it's different. It's a democratic action. It's a democratic action. It's a public action. And that is different from lobbying.
But NGOs, often the core where NGOs receive funds from is a huge issue.
Yeah, that's a cause of concern. That's a cause of concern. NGOs, many NGOs are doing lobbying.
Right.
That I agree.
Let me get in Vikram Mehta on that. Vikram, you listen patiently to the different voices, and it's interesting how you swung through the spectrum of different views on what exactly lobbying is. As somebody who's represented a very powerful US company as well, and of course Shell has often been under issue of lobbying and the powerful oil lobbies in the US, where do you see this coming from here? And do you agree that sometimes in countries like India and countries like Mexico, where perhaps the local laws under the FCPA, which Dilip cited, are not so strong here, is this a cause of concern?
You know, Sonia, there are three issues here. One is the concept of lobbying. The other is the law. And the third is the political discourse. Now, lobbying is very much part of the democratic process. Call it what you will, every segment of society lobbies. The politician lobbies for votes. The consumer lobbies to protect its interests. The businessman lobby to put forward their point of view. Sure, there are different sort of means available to these different segments, but ultimately every group in a democratic society has the right to further its cause, and it does so through legitimate means and The word lobby is one word that is used for putting forward one's point of view. Now, there is, of course, the second issue is whether or not...
But just one question on that. How can you compare politicians... Can you compare political lobbying or a politician campaigning for votes with actually a lobbying firm or a PR firm which is paid to do so? Is it when money is involved, does it take on a different tone?
That is a terrible example he put. Politicians make their
Let him finish what he's saying. Go ahead, Mr. Mehta.
How can he say that?
No, but let him finish what he's saying. Go ahead, Mr. Mehta.
Keep quiet on that.
Go ahead.
No, let me finish, because I know the politicians on your panel will want to object to what I've said.
Yes, I
As I said, you can call it what you will. You can call it lobbying, you could call it collective bargaining, you can call it campaign. But the fact of the matter is, and this is the point I'm going to make, is that every
citizen
of society does want to put forward his point of view. Now, let me please don't interrupt me, but there is, of course, the whole issue of the law. Does a lobbyist or does a campaign actually cross the line between legality and illegality? Clearly, if anyone has crossed the line, they should be investigated and they should be prosecuted. Then there's a third issue of the political discourse. Every politician will want to make a particular case for himself, for herself, and they will use the opportunity available to them. Now, I do not know the facts of this particular case, but there is, as Dilip Cherian has mentioned, a very strong U.S. law, and any U.S. company that is found to be in breach of the Foreign Corrupt Practices Act will be prosecuted. And it is clear from whatever the little reports that I've read in the papers that Walmart has started an internal investigation of its own to see whether or not their staff has crossed the line, whether their staff bent the law or whether they broke the law. But there's a thin line that divides the bending of a law and the breaking of a law.
Right.
And it might well be that on the basis of internal investigation, there are people who have crossed that line, in which case they will either lose their jobs or they will be prosecuted in law. But I think we're making a huge issue here without having facts on the table. We are trying to use the word lobby we're misusing the word lobby, and every one of us, if we were really honest, would recognize that we do ultimately want in a democratic society to find the means for transparent ways of putting forward our interest. Is what lobbying is all about.
Let me just transparent way, but of course in the U.S. as well, there's a huge storm. Thomas Friedman has said that U.S. lawmakers should wear T-shirts. All the brands, which he terms the lobbies, they endorse. Mr. Prakash Javdekar, come in on this point. And one argument, let me ask you: Narendra Modi himself hires a U.S. lobbying firm, APCO, to actually promote vibrant Gujarat. Dilip Cherian made the point. In fact, Patton Boggs, a lobbying firm used by Walmart, is also used by the Indian government to promote its own interests on Capitol Hill. So, isn't that an hypocrisy there in a sense?
See, Cherian and Vikram and others are so expert and are...
And Narendra Modi with APCO.
No, actually, one minute.
Yes.
They know actually what is happening. I have one question for them. Why then the five officers of Walmart have been suspended? And as Vikram was saying, that they have been suspended and will be taken action against if they must have not bended the law but have broken the law. What is that? To hold a seminar for a lobbying cause is not violating the law. What is that they have done? And that is what needs investigation. When Walmart is doing investigation about its Indian operation, Sonia, you have given all the time to all people. You must listen four sentences more. First, why is Congress shying away from investigation? Why they are afraid of the word I? They should not be afraid of investigation. And last but not least, who had changed the Chaco was arguing that they must have played who were opposing. I said, no, Baba, you were opposing in 2002. We were against FDI in 2002 also, and cabinet decided not to allow. But in 2012 also, we are the same. It is the 2002 which Congress was opposing, and now it is supporting. So they have changed the stand. So that needs to be investigated. What is the nexus?
Okay, so let me just ask, I'm just holding up again, we're talking about Walmart, but I'm talking, holding up something else. Now, this is the New York Life Insurance Lobbying Report filed in 2011, which says that $1.14 million was paid again for, and it says here, for issues related to Insurance Act in India. Now, again, this is going to be hugely controversial. But do you feel, Mr. Javedekar, and again, as I said, the NDA has been in government. I'm sure if you could go and pull out lobbying reports at that time, you're going to find lobbying firms have done the same thing when the NDA was in government as well. So what are you actually opposing? I asked you about Narendra Modi and the fact that the Gujarat government used a lobbying firm in the US. Why is it lobbying all right in the US? That's not bribery. But you're saying lobbying in a, the trickle down to India via the US is illegal.
It is not only that word lobby is taboo. If you are doing canvassing, you are doing PR relationship, or more than that, you are doing advertisement, you are building brands, it's entirely a professional job. Nobody is disputing that. What is that objectionable is, why in making advertisements people are get suspended? Why in making brand building people are suspended for breaking of law? Why they are being charged for anti-corruption practices? So there is a word anti-bribery. That bribe has come from Walmart itself. They are investigating.
No, but
why
those are two separate points. Dilip, you wanted to react.
This is a question of damned if you do and damned if you don't. The fact that Walmart has extremely rigid and tight internal controls is what has actually thrown up the need to figure out whether these officers had crossed any lines. It is not about doing seminars, preparing white papers, or lobbying with industry associations, which is what Walmart as well as companies across the world do. As I said, it is a simple fact that if companies don't know how to lobby, then we will all be in the situation where GMR is in Male, where they find that there's nobody to represent their interest.
No.
So when companies play the global game, they recognize that you have to go in there.
No, but should GMR then pay Indian politicians to lobby for it in the Maldives?
I think that I think that what they're missing out is GMR should be working in tandem with lobbying firms to ensure that
the issue is not about lobbying firms, the issue is about politicians here, surely.
Now, politicians, now the whole thing is being obfuscated about politics. I'm not getting into what politicians do. But the real problem is that if you have non-transparent policy making, you don't know which bureaucrat has pushed which button, which politician has pressed which button, and wherever he's pressed that button, why he's done that. And because it is non-transparent, you say lobbying is bad.
Let me get Mr. Chacko. Mr. Chacko, because the point is, these are two very controversial issues, the FDI policy initiative and also insurance I just mentioned. Obviously, the hackles of all opposition leaders will be raised when they find that US firms are also involved in lobbying. Innocent as it may be about policy level, but they do feel that then you are catering to US interest.
Sonia, in fact, you know, I feel that we are discussing, somebody, especially the opposition leaders, are trying to make an issue out of nothing. Mr. Dilip Charyan has made it very clear that what is lobbying in the American context. I can understand this Javedkar party or Mr. Rajesh party, they would want to make anything they are getting against the government. But why should informed persons like Mr. Saugat Roy, who knows what is happening, see, according to the American law, giving bribery to anybody or giving bribes to anybody outside their country also is a criminal offense. And that is not what is reported. How the government of India know anything detailed about what was reported in the American Congress? And where is the issue? And where is the Congress running away? Where is the government shying away? This is purely a political allegation. Absolutely, there is no...
All of you all happy when you got up and read the newspapers this morning? You said you have something to slam the government on.
Mr. Chacko is a good friend of mine.
He is an articulate
spokesman for the Congress, but unfortunately spokesman for a lost cause. What is the question,
this
Sonia?
Is after they won the FDI.
I am happy that Chacko and
Mr.
Dilip Charyan are on the same page.
Mr. Dilip Charyan is also taboo.
They are on the same page. They represent
Saugat
similar interests.
Parted company only recently.
Sonia, yes. The question is very simple in my mind. The question is, Walmart is a company
which is alleged to have paid bribes in Mexico. One, Walmart is a company whose employees have been penalized for paying bribes in India. Now you read in the papers that Walmart has spent 25 million in last 4 years to have access to the 500 billion retail market in India.
It's only part of the 25 million.
Part of the 25 billion, even in this year, 2012.
And the US lawmakers, not to India.
Please, please. And who have they lobbied with? They've lobbied with US lawmakers, including members of Senate, House of Representatives, Board of Trade, and the Department of State. Now, what we are interested in finding out, that who are the people who were contacted by this US lawmakers, who were approached by Walmart through lobbying, who have they influenced in India?
Are you talking about influence or bribery? Because they're two different things.
Saying
US lawmakers paid Indian lawmakers?
See, what, without substantial proof, I cannot say anything. Now it is only proof that Walmart has spent 25 million on lobbying in general, 3 million this year. They spent it in lobbying to US politicians. I have no proof that these people paid any Indian politicians, but as a political person, I have a hunch that Indian lawmakers, particularly those who are very vocal in supporting entry of Walmart into India, must have been influenced. I have said it openly,
yes,
in the House.
No, and the BJP has
the US Secretary of State visited India. And after that, government went into action.
But let me just ask Mr. Rajesh, was this point of lobbying, while we debate lobbying in US, the larger issue, and that's really, I think, of what's happening in India, the question of political funding, that's completely opaque. I think, in fact, the left is one of the few parties which actually reveals its sources. When we look at corporate lobbying within India, that's a completely grey area. At least here you have disclosure reports. Why do we see that not changing? That's really where the scandals will be.
First of all, thank you for the compliment, because left has never received corporate funding, and we are the party, CPIM is the party which demands that there should not be corporate funding of political parties, and there should be state funding of election and political parties. That is our position.
But you have huge earnings.
Yeah.
412 crores or something.
We have earnings, and we have revealed the sources also. Even
rich,
MPs like us, our and salaries to the
working class, they have got
what does this lobbying means? This lobbying is nothing but influencing policy making and decision making through backdoor, through unethical means. It may be legal in United States, but everything which is legal may not be ethical. So lobbying is unethical, and that lobbying takes place in India also. So this lobbying tightens the grip of corporate control over the state machinery.
Mr. Javdekar, come in on that point. When you talk about lobbying, many have said that in India the issue is that lobbying is associated with crony capitalism, and the problem in India is that capitalism is associated with crony, that we are actually blurring the distinctions, and by doing that, it's not good for anybody, it's not good for corporate governance, it's not good for corporate ethics, and it's not good for political ethics either. Can we paint everything with the same brush? Is all corporate funding bad? Are all corporates bad? Do we want to throw them out of India? What is the larger message you're giving?
You're asking me?
Yes.
No, I absolutely say nothing against ethical corporates, and I have nothing to say for the word lobbying only, because as I said, PR firms, the campaign firms, the brand building firms, and that part of lobbying also, making the cause known to everybody.
Lawmakers, lobbying in the US includes meeting lawmakers. It includes meeting US politicians.
But influencing the lawmakers by paying something is definitely not acceptable in India. If there are entries that for certain decision, if some MPs are paid, what will be your reaction?
No, but where has that come from? Because that's not what the disclosure lobbying report says. Walmart is not saying it's paying either US politicians or Indian politicians. That assumption is not borne out by fact.
No, Sonia, The question is actually simple. I don't know why Mr. Javdekar.
No,
the question is whether your way corporate's way of influencing politicians is transparent or opaque. As you said a little while ago, that whether the corporate funding is transparent or opaque, whether corporate influence peddling is transparent or opaque, that is the main question.
Vikram Mehta, corporate influence
that
peddling,
is issue.
As I said, the words bandied around, do you want to, what's your take on that? Do you think lobbying equals to crony capitalism in India? Because that's the charge in a sense.
Absolutely. It is, you see, crony capitalism is entirely a new thing that we are witnessing under UPA.
Let me just say, Mr. Mehta is on that, Mr. Javdekar. I was actually asking him that question. Go ahead, Mr. Mehta.
Okay.
Yeah. Lobbying, as we have all agreed, I hope, is a legitimate form of democratic discourse. Lobbying, in some sense, actually breaks the nexus between business houses and politicians. If it is legitimate and transparent, it makes it clear what the company is paying, why is it paying for a particular, why is it paying for a particular course of action, who is it trying to influence. It's all above board. Clearly, if the expenditures are below the surface, if they're illegal, that is something that goes beyond the pale and should be prosecuted. But crony capitalism, the very word crony capitalism, suggests that it is happening in the shadows, it's happening behind the scenes, and it is something that is illegal. What I am really trying to say is that when we have a lobbying firm or a PR firm or any form of interest group promotion that is legitimate and above board, it actually makes the whole issue much more transparent. You would find it very much more difficult to establish relationships that would be condemned as crony capitalism, right, if indeed we accepted that every segment of society, every interest group does have the right to put forward its point of view, right, and so long as it's within the framework of the law.
I think that's really the key point, because I think one thing to help in India is if we could get a lobbying disclosure report like Walmart filed in India, if that actually had to be filed here in the US, I think that would really make a crucial difference. But as we talk about lobbying and Mr. Chacko's point of who was actually paid, those who were for or against, I have to play the soundbite of the day. The Samajwadi Party said we must investigate this, and it couldn't have been offered to Samajwadi Party MPs because none of us speak English. Then, of course, Ram Gopal Yadav contradicted him by speaking the Queen's English on the quotas bill. Let's have a look.
Samajwadi Party ऐसी पार्टी है जिसके किसी नेता को अंग्रेजी नहीं है, तो सबसे बड़ा प्रमाण तो यही है कि किसी विदेशी कंपनी की लॉबिंग में समाजवादी पार्टी का कोई नेता हो नहीं सकता.
इज अ वेरी डिस्टर्बिंग न्यूज एंड वी हैव डिमांडेड दैट द प्राइम मिनिस्टर शुड कम इन द हाउस एंड एक्सप्लेन इफ द मनी हैज बीन गिवन फॉर लॉबिंग फॉर इंडिया. Right. Walmart in India, it's a very serious issue.
But clearly Walmart could afford to hire interpreters, but as I said, bizarre games politicians play at the end of the debate. But let's see how this plays out over the next few days. The difference, of course, having been made clear between the corruption allegations, the internal investigation by Walmart, and this lobbying report they filed in the US Congress. Thank you very much, all my guests, for joining me tonight. Let's just move across to the other